Hi, this is my girlfriend Fanny, and she's going to tell you a little bit about herself.
Hello, I'm Fanny, and I'm 14 years old, and I'm an Army NCC in Seattle, and I'm 13 years old. My parents are the defective flight mission, and we're going to go to the 2015 street, and they've got the same girl and their wife with them, so I thought I'd help my mom. And I went downstairs to do the work, and when I opened the lid, took the clothes out, it started spinning. And my arm was that hot, and the clothes that were in the washer started to spin out with the clothes, and then it kind of just spun my arm off, but it was connected by the little bone that I dangled it really bad, and then it went to the
end. About the fascination that you don't have out there, and she will tell you about what she has to offer.
I think soon I told you about vaccination. I decided to do a photo session of my own. I have 2 sets of photos, which is going to have 15 pictures each for $40. And since I enjoyed my picture taking so much, I decided to do a video. And that will be available next month.
Tammy's photo sets are available right now. And if you would like to order them, just drop me a note along with your order of set 1 or 2, and we'll get them out right away. I hope you enjoy meeting Tammy, and right now we're going to briefly discuss our special situation. You know, Tammy, I know it's like being on the computer, but what's it like being just having an
app? Well, I guess I have to sit by the website. It's kind of bad. I get a lot of looks from people, and I like to be able to show them that I can do anything that they can do with two hands. And I like to let people be amazed, so I show them I can do anything that they can do. But bad times are when you know you have your hands that you're making something cut. I never got myself in a glove. I can't wear gloves, I couldn't put a glove on my arm if I wanted to. So I had to buy mittens, and I don't like to pay kids full price because I know I'm only going to use one. You know?
Yeah, it's like when I go to the church, I hate buying the church to see. But since I've got my artificial legs, you know, it's not the best.
Yeah.
Because you got something to put you on now.
Yeah.
So that makes it a little bit easier. I found like going up and down the stairs is a little hard. Especially if the stairs are spinning on my feet. It's a little bit difficult. But other than that, I don't try to climb ladders. That would be kind of hard. I'm not going to be kind of hard for you too.
Yeah, it is. And it really helps. I have to.
Yeah.
It was 14 years coming.
I've been working for 11 years.
11 years?
Yeah, 12 years ago.
I must have been older. And you've had a lot longer, so you know what it's like.
I think we have a little bit more time to adjust and to perfect doing different things. It may take a little bit longer,
yeah.
But you develop a different way of using the bathroom or mopping the floor, or instead of standing, you kind of sit on your butt. But then you can see things close to the floor and you get it cleaner too. So you just develop a different way of doing things.
The whole life's a mean, like, you do the things that you have to do every day, you know, like, basic things that you just have to do, that you just have to go about doing on a different way to do them.
But, you know, if it's done well, then you've got a good attitude about yourself, and you're comfortable, you know, with it. And finding out feedback, you know, if there are gentlemen out there that prefer you this way, you know, that really find you attractive because of it.
Yeah.
You know, and then if you start corresponding with them, and they find out that there's other things about you that are, you know, equally interesting, it's kind of great too.
Yeah.
How do you feel about yourself? Yeah.
Well, at first, I didn't believe it. I just thought, no, it's true. But then there are all kinds of people in the world that are expecting this thing to help you when I tell them, you know, what we have to offer. I'm not sure I'm going to tell them, but I
have to do it. That's true. I kind of wondered about it at first, you know, how I feel about the vaccination, you know, that they have, because I imagine they run into a lot of opposition where people think they're doing, you know, because they find that they're doing it.
Yeah.
Because we are, with the loss of a limb or whatever, but it's kind of neat. It makes me feel really special.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah, I know it does.
At first, when I first knew that I had to have the application, I thought that no man would want it, and I just, you know, I thought it would really be hard to deal with, but yet, once I was comfortable with it myself, and didn't mind being non-morbid, it helped me overcome it. Finding out that there's men out there that have this vaccination just makes it more attractive, you know. I've got my artificial leg now, but yet I think a lot of the men would rather see me without it, you know, so maybe I would attend the day this month. You know, trying to find something out there that would really be attractive.
How about sports? How do you feel about sports?
I haven't really tried all that much. I thought of getting into some skiing.
Yeah.
I think that would be a lot of fun. Snowmobiling was on there for a lot of years. That's a lot of fun.
Yeah.
You have to learn a different way to set on it, because you tend to, when you turn the corner, you tend to slide over.
Really?
And off,
yeah.
Especially if you're turning right, because you have nothing over here to hold you.
Yeah.
So when you turn right and you lean into your corner, your butt tends to slide that way and off you go.
Yeah.
You gotta set a different way and make sure that you don't fall off. But other than that, golfing, I might try golfing.
Golfing? Yeah. I think that needs to be interesting. Golfing? Yeah. I like to play skiing too. I've always wanted to ski. And the first month I got a set of skis and boots and pants. And I'm all ready to go, so I figured I got to go for it.
You probably need to go out this month.
Yeah.
A lot of snow.
Yeah, we need some snow. I'd like to learn how to golf, but I'd like to be a better golfer than my father.
Did you do that?
Yeah, he used to do that. He does. And I've never spent a lot of time with my father because he goes into sports, and I've never done any sports in my life. And I really wish I would have. It's cool that they don't to do it, so they taught my swim classes and cycling classes. So now here I am, 22 when I'm 23 and don't know anything about sports.
I don't think it would take you long to pick it up, so it's like with anything else, as long as you've got a positive attitude. Sports is the reason you give it everything you got. I think, you know, you're going to succeed.
Yeah.
Because you're going to
Yeah, I think you can do anything in this world you want to do. Even though if I only get one arm, there's still more than one arm, there's still more than I can do. And if I want to apply myself, I mean, I really have to want to do it to be able to feel fun. So, you know, I feel tempted to what I'm doing all the time. That's another thing that I noticed since I lost my arm, that you really have to pay attention more to what you're doing than what you know, doing before. Like, I know myself, I gotta keep my eye on my hand, and my heart, the hand and eye, the coordination, to try to improve since, you know, since I had a few months, so I know that I'm going to constantly keep an eye on what I'm doing. Maybe it's because I want to keep an eye on this hand so that I don't eat this one.
Yeah, I think you really become protective of, you know, like, I'm really protective of my right leg.
Yeah.
So you tend to be a little bit more careful in certain things like walking in the snow and
yeah.
You know, if I hate to fall. And once I do fall, it takes me time to collect your faculties, you know,
yeah.
Because you're scared and you don't know if you're really hurt or not, and you got to get your wind back and your confidence in order to get back up, especially on the snow. It's funny how people take doodling for granted.
Yeah.
And I was the same way too until I lost my life. And then I come to realize that you can't take those things for granted. You know, you have to take care of them and be good to them and
just pay attention all the time. You don't have to.
Yeah. Yeah, that's been a lot too, but I don't know, I want to make sure that nothing happens to my right leg, although I don't know, I have a circulation problem with the way my blood circulates, and I'm fearful that I would have to, you know, maybe one day have my leg on the answer to the but I have to take good care and make sure that if I'm 7 feet on the left, that I'll be
it. Yeah, make sure you do that every day. I know.
Because it builds up with fluid. And the blood does circulate, right?
Yeah, I'm afraid. And so that's just for that. That's what you need to do.
Yeah.
Or do you have all these little two things you could do down there that warms the water and pours water?